When we listen, we forget. When we see, we remember. And when we do, we learn. Dear students, today we are going to learn to make 3D models of solid objects using their 2D nets. What do we mean by 2D nets? A 2D net of a model is a pattern on a paper which can be folded to make the 3D model. Here, we have with us various nets of 2D models. This is a 2D net of pentagonal prism. You can fold this net and make its 3D model. Here, we have with us a 2D net of square pyramid. You can fold this net and make its 3D model. Similarly, you can see we have placed here various 2D patterns on the piece of paper which can be folded and the 3D models can be made. Today, we are going to learn to make a model of a regular octahedron. Dear students, do you know what is a regular octahedron? A regular octahedron is a polyhedron which is made out of 8 equilateral triangular faces. This is the model of a regular octahedron. Now, we are going to learn how to make this model using its net. We have taken the net of this model. This is the 2D net, that is the pattern on a piece of paper which can be folded to make the model. What we are going to do is, for doing this activity, we require the following set of materials. Some sheets, a ruler, a pair of scissors, and a cello tape. Let us start the activity. We will take this net of solid and then we will take the pair of scissors and cut the outer boundary. As you can see that on this net, some folds are also drawn. So, you have to cut along the folds so that when you are folding them, the net can be transformed into a solid shape. Now, we are cutting this. Once you cut the shape, you get this net. Now, what we are going to do is, you can see the flaps here and you can see some lines drawn on this net. What you are supposed to do is, you have to fold along these lines. So, let us make the folds. Like this, you have to fold along the lines. These are the outer folds. And there are some lines drawn inside this net. You have to make folds along these lines also. So, be careful when you are making folds because you have to fold along all the lines drawn. So, when you make the folds, you will get this kind of a shape. Now, you have to fold it to make the required shape. For doing so, we will be using the cello tape and see how we are going to fold it. This is the edge and this is the flap. You have to put the flap on the edge and cover it using the tape. You take the flaps and fold it. This way, you are going to do the foldings on all the flaps. Once it is done, you are ready with the shape and we will be having the regular octahedron ready for exploration. Now, can you think of what will be the total surface area of this shape. Now, you can imagine the dimension of this. By actually measuring it, you can see the dimension of each side of the equilateral triangular face and think of the total surface area of this regular octahedron. What else you can do with this regular octahedron? You can verify the Euler's formula, that is number of vertices plus number of faces minus number of edges is 2. So you can count how many vertices are there, you can count how many faces are there, and you can count how many edges are there and verify the formula. Can you think of something else which you can do with this object? Oh yes, you can frame your own question as well. So you can make and play with this regular octahedron. Similarly, using these nets, you can make other sets of solid shapes, like using the net of a regular tetrahedron, you can make this shape. Similarly, you can make a 20 faces icosahedron using its net. This is a 20 faces icosahedron. Similarly, you can make a shape. This is a 12 face shape that is again a regular polyhedron, which is named as dodecahedron as it is having 12 faces and all of them are regular pentagons. Similarly, you can make this model of a cube and do lots of activities using these 3D shapes. So, students, you have seen that using the two-dimensional nets, that is the pattern which is there on a piece of paper, by folding, you can make interesting 3D models. And using the 3D models, you can imagine and do lots of various activities. Have fun in the maths classroom with these kinds of activities. Thank you.